Nice to be here. So I'm going to say a few words about Generation Z by way of introduction. The things I'm going to be sharing with you are in a white paper we'll be sharing with the people here. And the aim of that white paper really is to give you an idea of what we think is different about Generation Z and how to market to them. So I'd like to start off any conversation about generations with this guy, Karl Mannheim. In the 1920s, he came up with the idea of generations in the first place. And his thought was that when you were born, you're essentially a blank piece of paper. And if you are subject to historical events, significant historical events, they will start to form your personality. They'll have an impact on your personality and your thinking. And if those events are significant enough, then it'll start to create a generation of people with similar kind of thoughts. Now, in the case of Generation Z, which we're defining as 96 to 2016, there have been a great deal of very significant historical events that have created and lie behind this generation. So the reason we picked 96, it's the birth of Google. And in some senses, I think I'd suggest that you can't be in Generation Z unless you have access to the internet. So that was pretty significant. But you go through this list and there's everything from the birth of social media, Skype, and then on the social side, Barack Obama, but also quite a lot of negativity, wars on terror, wars generally, global financial crisis, a whole bunch of stuff like that. Now, what you might say, of course, is that all those kind of things impact not just on young people, but on all of us here. They've all had an impact on us. I think our thinking is that because Generation Z are born a blank sheet of paper, they actually exemplify the impact of all the historical events. Actually, everything that we are talking about today impacts on all of us. In a sense, everyone is Generation Z. So in looking at Generation Z, we're not just looking at the importance of marketing to young people, we're looking at the future of marketing per se. So that's why I think it's worth thinking about. So in terms of the research that we've done, I've called it a magpie piece of research because essentially it is based on some original research from Havas People and Havas, but it is also a piece of meta-analysis in that we've looked at all the research around the world on Generation Z and pulled it together and reached our conclusions. And essentially that research is from Western Europe, America and parts of Asia, such as Singapore and Hong Kong, and looks primarily at people between the ages of 14 and 21. And from this research, we think there's a whole bunch of firsts, things that really differentiate this generation in the marketplace. And I'm going to go through these. And I think the first, and probably the most obvious, is it's the first connected generation in the sense that it has always had access to the internet. Now, that's obviously important, but it's actually the way people are accessing the internet that is the most important thing, via mobile devices. There's a lovely quote here. Over half of 16 to 20-year-olds would rather give up their sense of smell than a central tech item. Now, for me, people don't understand how important smell is, and that's part of it, but also does symbolise how important tech is. And my thinking is this. The average age of getting a mobile phone is 12 around the world, and it's at that point when you get your mobile phone that you really enter the world of Generation Z, because that gives you that mobile compatibility. Now, once you have your mobile phone, it's this other first, the first know-everything generation. Because you have mobile communications, you have constant access to information. Now, information isn't necessarily knowledge, and this is obviously the age of post-truth, of false news, all that kind of thing. But I think the important thing here is that Generation Z always have access to an answer, and they actually do put a premium on being knowledgeable. Knowledge is important to this generation. But if you've got access to the internet all the time, you also become a real-time generation. In terms of entertainment, for example, 71% of teens, typical entertainment is streamed, typically by mobile devices. It's a generation that wants things now. And that can be a challenge, particularly in, for example, recruitment. I've put here, instant gratification is a byword of the digital age. Actually, instant gratification is a byword for Generation Z. It's the first video generation. And look at this. 67% could not live without YouTube. 51% could not live without Netflix. Certainly, videos are important in terms of communication. I think, in some senses, a lot of people say, well, that's got to be short-form video. But actually, I think there's increasing evidence that this generation also appreciates long-form video. They can take in a lot of information through this particular media. Certainly video is very important. And slightly different, but connected, I suppose, is it's also the first personalized generation. There's an interesting stat here, 62% are prepared to share purchase history details with brands. Now, this is very much aligned with Google's strategy, which I've put up here, to get up right to the creepy line but not cross it. And what Google meant with that is to gather lots of information about individuals so that marketing can be as personalized and relevant to the individual as possible. And if you look at Facebook, the commonest complaint about Facebook is not that people get a lot of advertising, it's that if you know me so well, why isn't this advertising more relevant? This is a generation that likes personalization but is quite often disappointed that it's not getting enough of it. And that again is connected with their relationship with brand. They've been marketed to since the day that they were born, and they do regard brands as important. So 60% of you consider brands to be an important part of the creative content online. So that sounds very positive to brands, but the reality is most brands disappoint them. And in the majority of cases, they wouldn't care if most brands disappear because brands on the whole do not understand how to market to young people. And one of the reasons behind that is, this is from the Havas research into meaningful brands, is that brands are pretty good at talking about themselves, but less good about talking about how they contribute to an individual's life, how they contribute to society. And this sense of meaning is very important to this generation. There's some research that Havas People do every year into what young people want from a career. And every year, the most important thing is meaning. They want a sense of meaning from their career. And also linked to that, they want happiness. And that sounds self-evident, but there's a change in the sense that traditionally people have said, if you work hard, you're successful, you will be happy. Whereas Generation Z's view is, if you are happy, you will be successful. So they're changing that kind of opinion around a bit. And again, linked to meaning is a sense of caring. And you could see this perhaps in last week's general election, where young people went out and voted. And they tend to vote. A lot of their votes were based around social issues. And 78% are passionate about social issues. So it's a very caring generation. And again, linked to that is this diversity. It's the first generation not to notice diversity. And I think that's a significant change. They notice if there isn't diversity in a room as opposed to the other way around, which is what other generations have tended to do. And this is a nice quote from American Eagle. This is one of their product line photographs, which indicates that actually as a result of this, in some ways, Generation Z is actually quite a nice, caring generation, a generation you'd want to hang out with. And again, linked to that sense of diversity, part of that reason of that comes because it's a global generation. If you look at the brands that they use, the media they use, from Google through to Facebook, through the devices they use, there's increasing sense of globalness about everyone using the same thing. And in many ways, if you are a 16-year-old in the UK, you probably have more in common with a 16-year-old in Delhi than you do with a 50-year-old in the UK itself. However, having said all that, for me, the strongest characteristic of this generation is it's the first really worried generation. And if you look at everything I've said so far, constant access to the internet, all that kind of thing, it's not surprising that they're worried because they're instantly aware of all the negative things that are happening in the world. They want a sense of their care, and they can see that the world, there's a lot of social injustice in the world, for example. They want meaningful careers, and they're worried about how their skills will be matched to employers and give them that kind of meaningful work. And there's a lot of work from people from the World Health Organization onwards which indicates that they're worried about almost everything. And it's this all-pervading sense of worry that I think is probably the defining characteristic. Now, in terms of how to market them, there's some very obvious things that I'm not going to talk about. They're all in the report, from be visual, be interactive, on-demand communications, all the things you would kind of expect logically from the first I've talked about. But also I think it's worth saying at the bottom here, maintain the human element. There is a temptation in marketing to this generation to just go social, for example. But actually, as probably not so surprising, 80% prefer face-to-face communications, face-to-face interaction. It does make you worry about the other 20% who don't, but on the whole, that is the way they prefer. So we're certainly not saying just, you know, go online, for example. However, that's good, but I think what's really interesting is if, as I would suggest, that this is a worried generation, how do you market to a generation generation that's essentially worried about everything? And this is from the British Journal of Psychology. how to deal with worry. There's lots of similar things. So learn to accept uncertainty, problem solve, don't worry, don't try to suppress, always try to lift your mood, all those kind of things. And what we thought was probably the best way to market this generation was to relate to your marketing to these kind of things that are going to alleviate worry. So here are some suggestions. And the first one is to imbue your marketing with a sense of care and purpose. This is fairly obvious. This is an example of a brand that is saying, look, it's not just about making money to us, it's about giving back to you as an individual and giving back to society as a whole. So this brand, which you may or may not have seen, Boxed Water is better, that's on all their products. And the point here is that obviously water is very environmentally unfriendly because it tends to be in plastic bottles, and this is a company that's making a stand on that as well as trying to provide good quality water. Understanding and contextualization is the second thing. It's, you know, people are worried, and it's showing people that you're not alone in having this concern, that there is someone there to support you through it. And I'm going to give you an example now of a piece of work that Havas has done. This is an Instagram campaign that I think actually quite nicely deals with this. The central message of this is about addiction. And when you get to the video, you realize by looking at all the pictures you've been following her that this woman has a problem with addiction to alcohol. And you've seen all these nice glamorous photographs, and that's what it comes to. And it is a fantastic conclusion to this video. It's a great shame you won't see it. But there will be a link. And it's a great example of an Instagram campaign. Really simple, very low cost. So anyhow, the next point I would say is lighten the mood and embrace positivity. I put this video here, which is Dancing Babies. It's one of the most popular videos with Generation Z. And also this one here, Calux, who's a vlogger. And the reason I put his, and it's another good Havas campaign. The reason I put that up is that we did that in conjunction with the Wembley FA Cup final. And what he does is he invites some people to Wembley and he put some pranks on them, that kind of stuff. But what was impressive to me about this was 850,000 views over the weekend just from that vlogger. And this kind of like, and I think vloggers and personal recommendations are very important to this generation. Going on with this is another example. This is a campaign that we did for Havas. These are the ads in their entirety with just Havas internship program. Now, hiring. I think it's a good example of how you can do really simple things that engage with this generation. Sharing and contributing, this is another example. It's about user-generated content. This is the Starbucks example, the White Cup campaign, and it was won eventually. That's the work of a Generation Z and shows how they like to get involved in these kind of things. And dealing with issues of concern. There's a number of examples, and this is about, so this is an issue of concern, how are we going to help this generation move forward? So this is an example of some work we did for Nationwide, in which this guy is talking about work experience. Another famous vlogger, and this is an example of a camp. I'm going to try and show you this video. There's a lot of things that you can do about marketing to Generation Z. There's some very practical things. But I think essentially we're dealing with a group of people that are in what I've described as a VUCA world. Right? It's a very uncertain, it's a very volatile world. And I think marketing, to be at its most effective, needs to deal with those concerns. It's no longer enough just to say, for example, here's a career. You've got to show, here's a career with meaning. Here is how we can add to your life and how we're adding to society as well. So thank you very much.